Hello everyone, I am Gagan Laddha, and in this particular video we will solve one question which many times such questions are asked in GATE exam. This particular question was asked in GATE 2000. This is a nut bolt type of questions, and most of the students find difficulty in solve such questions. So we will deal with this particular question. So the question says, a steel bolt having a nominal diameter of 20 mm and a pitch of 2.4 mm is used to connect two plates of 10 mm thickness. Okay, the aluminium tube having inner diameter of 22 mm and outer diameter of 44 mm is separating the plates as shown. The nut is pulled snug just tight and then given 1/3 additional turn. Find resulting stress in the bolt and the tube, neglecting the deformation of the plates. Young's modulus of steel and aluminium are given as 207 gigapascal and 67.5 gigapascal respectively. Okay, now what is this question saying? Let us first understand the question and the arrangement of this nut bolt carefully. Okay, so the question says, a steel bolt is having a nominal diameter of 20 mm. So here we are having a steel bolt. This is the steel bolt. This is having a nominal diameter of 20 mm. The diameter of this steel bolt is given as 20 mm. Okay, I will show you. So this is the steel bolt. And let's suppose the diameter is having, this is having a diameter of 20 mm, nominal diameter. Okay. Now, the aluminium tube with inner diameter of 22 mm and outer diameter of 44 mm is separating the plates as shown. Okay. So, there are two different plates and this is the aluminium tube which is separating these two plates. Okay. So, I will show you here. So, we are having these two plates. Okay. And let's suppose this is the aluminium tube. Okay. This aluminium tube is separating these two plates like this. Getting this? Okay. And then the nut is pulled snug just tight and then given additional 1/3 turn. Okay. So, this nut is first just tight. Snug means just tight. Okay. So, this is the initial arrangement. Okay. We are having a bolt having diameter 20 mm, then an aluminium tube, outer and inner diameter are given 44 and 22 mm respectively, and these are two plates of 10 mm thickness, and this nut we have just tight. Now, it is said that this nut is given 1/3 of additional turn. Okay. Now, the pitch of this pitch is also given. Now, what is pitch? Pitch is nothing but one complete turn hone mein kitna distance travel kar raha hai. When I am turning this nut by one complete turn, so bolt mein kitna distance travel kar raha hai, that is nothing but pitch. I will show you here. Okay. So, this is suppose nut bolt arrangement and this is our bolt. So, on rotating this by complete 360 degree, a complete turn karne mein, let's suppose this is the final position is like this. Okay. So, this is nothing but pitch. This distance is nothing but pitch. Okay. One complete revolution mein, one complete rotation of nut mein, jitna distance travel kar raha hai, that is nothing but pitch. Getting this? Okay. So, after it is just tight, then it is given 1/3 of the additional turn. 1/3 additional turn is mein aur diya ja raha hai. Okay, now let us understand this thing very carefully, that what is the meaning of this 1/3 additional turn? What is this 1/3 additional turn? So let's suppose this is we are having this arrangement. I will just show you here only. Suppose we are having this arrangement, a nut and bolt arrangement. Okay, and these are two plates. Which is separated by an aluminium tube like this. Okay. And this is our nut which is just tight like this. Okay. So, when we are giving 1/3 additional turn to this, then what will happen? Okay. So, pehle to ye samajhna hoga then ki humne jab isko completely tight kar diya hai, then how is it possible ki usme 1/3 additional turn de sake? Ye आखिर होगा कैसे? 1/3 additional turn और हो रही है, तो आखिर हो क्या रहा है इसमें? So, when we are giving 1/3 additional turn after tightening it completely, when we are giving additional turn of 1/3, तब क्या हो रहा है? Then this aluminium tube, this nut is applying a compressive force on this aluminium tube. ये nut क्या कर रहा है? This nut is applying a compressive force on aluminium tube like this. When I am giving additional turn to this, okay, this is applying a compressive force on this aluminium tube. Now, at the same time, this is applying a tensile force, because in equilibrium, when a compressive force is applied on this aluminium tube, equal magnitude ka tensile force is bolt mein lagna chahiye. ओके सो दिस इज द वेरी फर्स्ट कंडीशन. नट एंड बोल्ट इस तरह के अरेंजमेंट में क्या होगा, द वेरी फर्स्ट थिंग इज वॉट एवर फोर्स, कंप्रेसिव फोर्स इज एक्टिंग ऑन द ट्यूब, द सेम कंप्रेसिव फोर्स शुड एक्ट ऑन द रॉड और यू कैन कॉल इट एज बोल्ट. दिस इज द वेरी फर्स्ट कंडीशन. ओके वॉट एवर कंप्रेसिव फोर्स पी आर जितना रॉड में लग रहा है, जितना रॉड में टेंसाइल लग रहा है, दिस रॉड इज सब्जेक्टेड टू टेंसाइल फोर्स एंड दिस ट्यूब्स आर सब्जेक्टेड टू कंप्रेसिव फोर्स, सो द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ दिस फोर्सेज आर इक्वल, फर्स्ट थिंग. ओके नाउ व्हेन अ कंप्रेसिव फोर्स इज अप्लाइड ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर एल्यूमिनियम ट्यूब एंड अ टेंसाइल फोर्स इज अप्लाइड इन दिस रॉड और बोल्ट, देन वॉट विल हैपन व्हेन आई एम गिविंग एडिशनल टर्न टू दिस, दिस ट्यूब विल कंप्रेस एंड दिस रॉड विल इलोंगेट. एंड वॉट एवर डिस्टेंस दिस नट इज ट्रेवलिंग, ये नट जितना भी डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल कर रहा है आगे की ओर, डेट टोटल डिस्टेंस डेल एल, इसको ध्यान से समझो, दिस विल बी इक्वल टू टोटल डेल एल ऑफ ट्यूब प्लस डेल एल ऑफ रॉड. ओके वाई सो, बिकॉज दिस रॉड दिस इज इसमें ट्यूब में क्या लग रहा है, कंप्रेसिव लोड लग रहा है जिसके कारण इसकी लेंथ कम हो रही है, रॉड में टेंसाइड लोड लग रहा है जिसके कारण इसकी लेंथ बढ़ रही है. ओके सो कितना मैं टोटल इसको अंदर ले जा सकता हूँ, दिस नट कैन बी कैन ट्रेवल द डिस्टेंस, टोटल डिस्टेंस कितना ट्रेवल करेगा, जितना इसमें कंप्रेसिव के कारण जितनी इसकी लेंथ कम हो रही है प्लस टेंसाइल के कारण जितनी इसकी लेंथ बढ़ रही है, टोटल डेल एल विल बी इक्वल टू डेल एल ऑफ ट्यूब प्लस डेल एल ऑफ रॉड. गेटिंग दिस, सो दीज आर टू कंडीशन, ये दो कंडीशन अगर हमको समझ में आ गई तो फिर ये क्वेश्चन ईजिली हमसे बन जाएगा. गेटिंग दिस, द वेरी फर्स्ट कंडीशन, जितना कंप्रेसिव लोड ट्यूब में लग रहा है उतना ही टेंसाइल लोड बोल्ट में लगेगा, फर्स्ट थिंग. सेकेंड थिंग, वट एवर इज द टोटल चेंज इन लेंथ ऑफ ट्यूब, और यू कैन से डिक्रीज इन लेंथ ऑफ ट्यूब प्लस इंक्रीज इन लेंथ ऑफ बोल्ट, दैट विल बी टोटल ट्रेवल ऑफ नट विच इज इक्वल टू डेल एल हियर. गेटिंग दिस नॉट, ओके नाउ दिस टोटल ट्रेवल ऑफ नट ये हमको पता है, दिस डेल एल एज इट इज गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन, दिस इज गिवन वन थर्ड ऑफ द एडिशनल टर्न, वन थर्ड ऑफ द एडिशनल टर्न इज गिवन, दैट मीन्स टोटल इज कितना डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल करेगा, वन थर्ड ऑफ द टोटल पिच, वन थर्ड ऑफ द पिच, सो दिस विल बी इक्वल टू वन थर्ड ऑफ 2.4 और दिस विल बी इक्वल टू 0.8 mm, फर्स्ट थिंग. गेटिंग दिस नॉट, ओके नाउ दिस पी टी इज इक्वल टू पी आर, और यू कैन से दिस पी टी इज इक्वल टू पी आर, पी लोड इज इक्वल टू स्ट्रेस इंटू एरिया, सिग्मा आर इंटू ए आर इज इक्वल टू सिग्मा टी इंटू ए टी. गेटिंग दिस, ओके सो जस्ट पुट द वैल्यू, सो फ्रॉम हियर दिस सिग्मा आर बाय सिग्मा टी इज इक्वल टू ए टी बाय ए आर, एरिया ऑफ ट्यूब बाय एरिया ऑफ रॉड, ट्यूब इज हॉलो. ओके ट्यूब का अगर मैं क्रॉस सेक्शन बनाऊँ, इट विल बी लाइक दिस, दिस इज द आउटर डायमीटर ऑफ ट्यूब एंड दिस इज इनर डायमीटर ऑफ ट्यूब. ओके सो द एरिया विल बी इक्वल टू पाई बाय 4 डी आउटर स्क्वायर माइनस डी इनर स्क्वायर, 44 mm इज आउटर डायमीटर, 22 mm इज इनर डायमीटर, डिवाइडेड बाय 4 ट्यूब, द डायमीटर इज गिवन एज हाउ मच, 20 mm. ओके सो दिस सिग्मा आर बाय सिग्मा टी विल बी इक्वल टू 3.63, लेट सपोज दिस इज इक्वेशन नंबर 3. गेटिंग दिस, ओके सो फ्रॉम हियर वी हैव गॉट वन रिलेशन, दैट सिग्मा आर is equal to 3.63 of sigma t. Clear or not? Okay, now coming to second equation, sigma del l is equal to del t, del l t plus del l of rod. Okay, so solving this equation we will get what, total del l is equal to del l of tube plus del l of rod. Okay, this del l as we have determined is 0.8, so this will be equal to 0.8 is equal to, now what is this del l, del l as we know is what, pl by ae, or you can say sigma into L by E, P by A is sigma. Okay, so this will be equal to sigma T L T by E T plus sigma R L R by E R. Okay, T is the tube which is of aluminum, R is a rod which is a steel. Okay, so just put all the values, so this will be equal to 0.8 is equal to sigma T into length of tube and length of rod. Now what are the lengths given? So this tube is having the rod is having the length of LR is having the length 350 mm. Okay, now the tube, the aluminum tube, isme kya ho raha hai, this thickness will be subtracted, 20 mm, 10 plus 10 20 mm thickness is subtracted, so L of T will be equal to 330 mm. Getting the difference? Okay, so just put the values, so this will be equal to sigma T into length of T which is 330 divided by The tube is of aluminium and E of aluminium is given as 67.5 into 10 dash power 3. So, this will be 67.5 into 10 dash power 3 plus sigma r. Now, sigma r can be written as 3.63 of sigma t, okay, into length is rod of rod is 350 divided by E of rod, which is of steel. So, E is given as 207 gigapascal or 207 into 10 dash power 3 megapascal. Getting this one, okay. So, yahan se, because we are keeping this in megapascal, okay, ye hamara megapascal mein, this is in mm, this is also in mm, this is in megapascal, or you can call it as Newton per mm square. So, whatever sigma t we are getting from here, this will be in Newton per mm square or megapascal, okay. So, on calculating this, you will get the value of sigma t from here. So, this sigma t will be equal to 72.55 Newton per mm square. Okay, so this is the stress acting on the tube. Tube means on the aluminium tube. Okay, now as we know, sigma r is equal to 3.63 of sigma t, 72.55. So this sigma r will be equal to 263.36 Newton per mm square. Okay, so this is how you can solve such question. So the stress acting on the tube is 72.55 megapascal, and on rod it is 263.36 megapascal. Okay, so this is how you can, we can solve the questions of this nut and bolt type of questions. Getting this? So if you like this video, just hit like button below, subscribe to our channel along with bell icon to get regular notifications of our video. If you want more subject related videos, you can download our free mobile application Gate Lectures for Mechanical. You can have complete course of mechanical engineering from our website www.sngateacademy.com. So all the best, stay motivated. Thank you so much.